बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामुअलैकुम टू एवरीवन एंड वेलकम इन कैम्प बूस्टर विद दिया शहजादी। आई वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू विद द न्यू एंड एक्साइटिंग चैप्टर, दैट इज द थर्ड चैप्टर ऑफ अवर नाइन्थ क्लास एंड द टॉपिक दैट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट अकॉर्डिंग टू द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द एलिमेंट, दैट इज द साइलेंट फीचर्स ऑफ द पीरियोडिक टेबल। द पीरियोडिक टेबल दैट वॉज फॉर्म्ड बाय द मॉडर्न पीरियोडिक टेबल दैट वॉज डिजाइन फ्रॉम द साइंटिस्ट with that has the some silent features that becomes its more distinguishable from the other periodic table that were made for the classification of the elements from the other scientists. The properties of the this classification of the periodic table has the silent features. Here are the different silent features of the of this periodic table, that the period or the table consists of the seven horizontal lines or the rows that are called the periods. The periodic table is consist of basically the periods, groups and the transition elements, and the divided into the subatomic particles like the subshells sp df, and also with the transitions metals non-metallites and the halogens and the different noble gases. The periodic table was designed to silent or to distribute the elements into their periodic properties. The properties are the elements with the same properties were placed in the same groups or the same periods, and the classification was based upon the atomic numbers. So the silent features of this periodic table are the different. The silent because this table is consist of the seven horizontal lines that are called the period. The first period consists of only two elements, that is the hydrogen and the helium, and the second and third period consist of the eight elements. The horizontal lines in periodic table are called the periods. That periods are consist of basically the periodic table consists of the seven periods that are assigning the name for the one period, period number 2, period number 3 and the period number 4, for etc up to the period number 7. And the periods contain the different numbers of the elements in their structures. In the first period there are the only two elements, that are the hydrogen and the helium, and the second period contain the eight elements, third also contain the eight elements, and the fourth and fifth period consists of the 18 elements, and the sixth period has the 32 elements, while the seventh period has the 23 element, and it is incomplete. It's incomplete due to its undiscovered element. There is a space or the place where we will place the undiscovered element in the later situation when they will discover. So the periodic table was designed like this. According to the periods, the period elements of the period show the different properties, and here is a period. We can see that here is a five given seven periods, that five, six and seven are incomplete due to the lanthanide and the actinides. The start line in a block, that is from the cerium and the barium, and that is the star which remains our, that the here is the lanthanide that will placed into the further in classification of the elements. And the first period is consist of the hydrogen and the helium. Second period is consist of the lithium, barium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine and the neon, and up to so on. The third, fourth period have the second and third period has the 8 elements. Fourth has the 18 element, as well as the fifth period contain the 8 elements. This was the classification for the periods according to the classification of the modern periodic table. Okay, now we move towards the periods. What are the periods? The period, first period is called the short period, that contain the two elements. It's a hydrogen and the helium. And the second period and the third period also contain the 8 element, and these are called the normal period because they contain the 8 elements in each element. And the second period that has the 8 element, that has hydrogen, helium, lithium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, and at the nitrogen neon, that is a noble gas. Fourth and the fifth period are called the long period, and each of them consists of the 18 element. Whereas the 6th and the 7th period called the very long periods. In this period, after the atomic number of the 57 and the 89, the two series of the 14 elements of each below the normal periodic table was kept to manageable and the representable form of the periodic table. The two series started from the lanthanum, that is the atomic number of the 57, that is called the lanthanides, and the actinides, that has the atomic number of the 89, and these are called the actinides. all the periods except the first period started with the alkali metal, because the first period started from the hydrogen, that is not an alkali metal. It's a hydrogen atom is a single element. So the periods are excepting from the first period, it started from the alkali metal and end at the noble gases. The last period is of the noble gases. It was observed that the number of the element in a period is fixed because by maximum numbers of the electron which can accommodate in the particular valence shell of the elements. These were the classification about the periods. For the group, the silent feature about the groups. Here are the groups classification. Well, there are 18 vertical columns that are named from the 1 to 18 from the left to right in the periodic table. These are called the periods groups, and the elements of the group show the similar chemical properties because all the elements are placed with the same chemical properties in a same groups. So they are named as the groups. Elements are classified into the four blocks depending upon the type of the subshell that they have in the electrons. On the basis of the completion of the particular subshell, according to the groups, we have the different groups according to the names of these, that the group 1, as the here is a group that are named from the group 1 to group 18. Here are the elements which were placed into the groups according to their chemical properties, that have the same chemical properties. Okay, in this step we are learning about the how many groups in a present in periodic table and what are the elements that are placed in them. Group 1 consists of the single item hydrogen and the lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium and the francium. Although the elements of a group do not have the continuously increasing the atomic numbers because there are the random increasement of the atomic number because they are not placed in line in a row, that are the horizontal row that call the periods. In the periods there were the addition of the element or the one electron is a regular pattern, but in the groups there is a no regular pattern for the increment of the atomic numbers, so they have the irregular atomic number. The similar electronic configuration in their valence shell. It is the reason elements of the groups that are called a family. We called the groups into the family. For example, all the groups one element have the one electron in their valence shell, so they are called the family number one of the alkali metal. The group number one, that will call the alkali metal, and its electronic configuration will be same for all the elements that are placed in a single groups, that will be 1NS1. It means that number of shell will be different, but the last shell subshell will contain the only one electron in that. And the group second 1 and 2 and the 13 to up to the 17 contain the normal elements. In the normal elements, all the inner shell will be complete filled with the electrons. Only the outermost shell are the incomplete. The second is the alkaline earth metals, and the 13 is the bromine family, that is started from the bromine. And the 14 elements, group number 14, that contains the 4 electron in their valence shell, that is called the carbon family. And the 5 electron that are placed in the valence shell, they were called the 15 group number, and this will be the nitrogen family. And the 6 electron will be in the 16 group, that is the oxygen family. And the 7 electron with the halogen family, that will be called group number 17. And the group number 18, that contains the 8 electron that has the completed octet, will contain the noble gases that has the general electronic configuration of the octet, and these are the stable elements. Blocks. The periodic table was designed like a blocks in where the elements were placed, but the blocks have the different names according to on the basis of the completion of a particular subshell. The elements with a similar subshell electronic configuration was referred to the blocks. Here are the four blocks in a periodic table named after the name of the subshell in which the process of the completion of the electron. There are the S, P, D and F blocks shown in figure that will assign the different names due to the S, P, D, F on the number of the electronic configuration. For example, the valence shell subshell, there will be obtained the one electron, so this will be belonging from the S block of elements. Okay, Now the elements of the group 18, the 13 to 18, where the valencies of the subshell are not completed, they are called the F block due to their incomplete valence shells, and each shell period contains the groups starting from the groups to groups, and these are called the transition metals. Here are the blocking one, where the alkali metal and the alkaline earth metal are placed in the S block and the P block started from the bronze to up to the noble gases, that are the helium, up to the last member of the noble gases. This will be placed in the P block, and the transition metals that are starting from the group number 3 to up to the group number 12, this will be equal towards the block number D, and the last two lanthanide and the actinide are the 14 element series of the periodic table that are placed for the convenience in below the periodic table for the just to give the better look towards the periodic table, that are called the F block elements. Here is a complete periodic table that was designed according to the modern periodic table that was based upon the atomic numbers. Here is a period. We know that the period number of period in a periodic table, that are the 7, and the group number are the 18, and the periodic table contains the alkali metal, alkaline earth metal, transition metals, other metals and the other non-metals, and halogen, noble gases, rare earth elements, and the lanthanides and the actinides. In the periodic table, in the picture, we can clearly see that we are distinguishing the elements as whether they are the alkali metal, alkaline earth metal, noble gases, transition metals with the different colors. So we can just view that here is the classification for the periodic table. That is the end of our topic, and let's move toward the test. Here is a test for everybody. How many elements are placed in a fourth group? You have to just read this question and relate them to the previous slides I just read. Now I just treat you all people, and this is a just activity. Keep yourself in contact with the study and touch with study with a deeply interest, and the camp is not a difficult subject, it's an easy subject, so make it easy for yourself and the others. Take care of yourself. Thank you for watching my videos, and never forget to subscribe, like, share my videos, and give me thumbnails and likes my videos and share my videos to your friends. Take care of yourself and others. Allah Hafiz.